Okay, good evening, dear friends. Here we would like to do a drawing. Blue sky, and first let me choose the page a little bit smaller so that we put everything in place. And we want to have a blue sky, so the color should be blue color. Where is the color sign? Color of this one, window. Okay, color pack. We need a color pack. We need the brush pack. We need the color editor. Oh yes. Okay, finally we found the color editor. So blue sky. Mostly blue, we will use this here and there. Little bit too light, right? And the size is not large enough. We increase the size. Okay. So far much better. Increase more the size. Oh, now we are using the spray, actually. The sky. And the flow much stronger. Use this color. Use the upper flow. 100% flow. This blue, different kind of blue to make it prettier. Okay, brush, we took it away. We will take it away. Now we need this kind of screen because we need much darker blue, right? Much darker blue. Okay. So this is a blue sky. And we need some white, spray some white color as cloud. We should use this white color and the airbrush will be a little bit smaller. A little bit smaller. Okay. Okay, I think this is good. Good. White cloud. Now we want to have some texture on this, so we will use a brush with a certain texture. The size does not have to be too big, and the color should be pretty white and very light blue. Okay, let's see. What will happen like this? Larger opacity. Much larger. M much larger, much larger. Now we need some of this white color, much larger, the white color, color, edit image. We will need the color editor. Color editor, okay. White color, okay. The white is a little bit too Now we will need some smearing tools. Seems a little bit too big, the smearing tool, but should be okay. Sharpen it a little bit, okay. And add some more white color. We will need some more white color as our previous brush. Okay. Uh-oh, too much. Okay, we will go back to our texture. And the size smaller. Okay, that should be sufficient. Size smaller, even smaller. Now we need to smear it a little bit. we do not want to see it too sharp, right? The real cloud is not so sharp. Now we need to sharpen a little bit of our cloud. So there is no end how much you can do. Just make sure you know where to stop. It's very important. You got to stop, otherwise there will be no end. You spend your life doing the same thing. And now we sharpen it a little bit. Why this? I just want to sharpen it. And it does not have to be any other color. Okay. So this is one layer of the cloud. We will just stop here. There will be no end. And now we will need to add another layer. So here I will put the layer editor, add a new layer, and we will lock this layer. And now this second layer, we will use green color. And let's use a brush tool. We will use a brush. I always okay. Like, dear friends, here we will do another layer we have added a new layer and choose a green color. Let's see the color palette. Color editor. And it seems not enough with this palette, so we will use this palette. It's always good to start from something lighter, right? And we will use airbrush instead of using brush itself, use airbrush, so it has a much softer feel. So let's see, we are working on the second layer editor here. So we work on this layer instead of the first layer, cover it up. So we will put this one aside. Start to put on the green. The green grass to touch the green grass of home. Then we add a little bit of darker green. You do not want this color to be too even, right? Make sure your color is. Now, let me do. Okay. So this way we can see. Now we will need some even darker color. How do we get even darker color? We can do the density of the green. Okay. That is good. That's my brush. Good. And we are in the grassland, so it's not only pure green, right? There should be some brown color here and there. Okay. So we will need some brown color because it's grassland. Okay, so the texture is roughly okay. We will make the airbrush thinner, much thinner here. And the flow, 100% flow, make a much stronger edge so that we can see. Okay, let's see. Does not have to be too straight. Do not think it's the horizon. It might be the horizon, but with mountain line, not mountain line, mountain line. Something. Okay, that's my computer not so clean. Okay, so that's it. And now we will plant our tree. And I want to fix this layer and add a new layer for the tree. And the tree trunk will be brown color and very dark brown color. Very dark, almost black brown color. So we have one tall tree here, one short tree here. What is happening here? Erase it out. Oh, nothing. Okay, so this one we will use brush, not we will use, I always like this brush. I am sorry, I'm just so addicted to this brush. And relatively see. So protect these two layers, working on this layer. Oh, that's too wide. I still have no idea all these brushes, the size. Opacity, very strong. Okay, so here is one tall tree and one light tree. Tall tree, short tree. One tall, one short. And just two. On which side? Almost the middle, not exactly, not totally middle. Okay, here. Here we will have this tall tree. And here we have this short tree. Okay. Now we will need really thin size for its brush, for its branch. Okay. Oh, it's too thin. Okay, this is our tree. Now I will make it much stronger color here. Okay, almost black. Now I need to increase the size of it so that I can see clearly. Now we are working on this tree. This is so not easy. I think I will need an eraser to erase. Sometimes when you make a mistake, you just need to erase it out. Now I will go back to our brush. Here is the tall tree. Okay, so the tree we have finished. Now we need to, the tree trunk we have finished. Now we will now we will add leaf. And I do not want to damage what I have done already. So I lock this layer and add another layer for the leaf. So we make it smaller so that we can see clearly. And we will use the textured brush. Let's look for a texture. This is the texture we want. You can see a little bit and make it a little bit larger size, a size with heavy, size with light, opacity, randomness. Okay, and the color we will choose from light green to dark green. And here is the color palette. Okay. So we are working on this layer. Make sure you are working on a new layer. I choose this green. We always start from lighter color. That is too big. A little bit too big, but it's okay. We want to make the first layer of it, and then we will refine it. Okay. And even some yellow color on it. And then some dark green color. Okay, we need to reduce the size of it. It's a little bit too much. Now we will do a much smaller. Okay. And you want the color to be, you can almost see a layer of color. So, yeah, so some place is more, make it smaller. Okay. Here we have more. I actually did something wrong, but we will fix it. How about that? So we put dark color all over, okay? Cover it up with dark color. Everywhere. This is a dark color. Dark color. Let's get this tree even. So this tree does not have any layer for now. Right, does not have a layer. It's very much like bulbo. Oh yeah, we should have the trunk. Dark. And now we will add layer. How do we add layer? We add sunshine on it, right? The sunshine, when we have sunshine, it's lighter. So we use this light green. Here. It's too strong. So we use the opacity much lighter. So we use this green because there is sun. It's too strong. We do not want to have so strong green. Okay, now I will use much light. At this time, we need to use this kind of green. Okay, that's too much contrast. better. Not so much better, but a little. So add some dark shade here and there. So the tree is more as that feel of layer, right? This tree is not. Need to have some contrast, some place much dark. Okay, so we have two trees. Shall we have some shadow of this tree? So we should have some shadow of this tree. Not good, not good, not good, not good, not good. Let me erase this. Erase it. Size, larger size, 2C. Okay, now we change the shadow. Now we will do the shadow, a little bit green and dark shadow. Okay, I think this is good. Actually, we should use an airbrush for this shadow. Erase it. Make sense? Erase it. Okay, we will use airbrush. Let me find airbrush. and size not too big, not too thin, 100% flow, and darker color. Let's see if we can do it. I think I need to add the layer of green a little bit this layer we need to add more. Open it, this layer, lock, everybody lock, and the green layer. We will need more of this green layer. So we use airbrush, green. Size. Flow. What happened? We are working on this layer. Okay, now we will work on this layer, lock it, work on this layer. Work on the shadow, much thinner. Much darker color. Yeah, add some gray. Oh yeah, it's covered. Anyway, This is beyond me. This is as much as I can do. Put everything away. Bon appetito. Not easy at all.